This is the first of two rose windows for the Cathedral of the Holy Name of Jesus. This window, the subject is Saint Joseph. And we have an intimate portrait of Jesus and Joseph in the middle, surrounded by several scenes of the life of Saint Joseph. There's two important episodes where an angel appears to Saint Joseph in a dream. In the first one, the angel appears to Joseph in a dream and tells him that it is okay to marry Mary. So here we have the marriage of Mary and Joseph. The second dream that Joseph has, the angel appears to him in a dream and tells him, get the family out of danger and escape to Egypt. So here is the flight into Egypt. And we do a lot of research on the internet, even though this is a very old school technique done by hand, we still engage the internet a lot. So I managed to find a nice landscape from the internet of Egypt and put that right in the background here, you can see. Over here we have the Holy Family. Jesus and Joseph are sawing a log. I wanted to invent a scene where they were really engaged together, working together. Jesus is more of an adolescent in this version. And down here we have the death of Joseph with Jesus and Mary appearing, and the angels on either side are simply in a position of mourning. And they essentially, in terms of the composition, they balance out the angels that are up here. So I'll have some of the same colors in the wings, same color phenomenon in all four corners here to sort of unify the design. All the medallions and the entire window are surrounded by borders of lilies, which is a traditional flower associated with Saint Joseph. We have lots of other little iconographic details here, wedding rings on either side of the marriage. We have lots of carpentry tools surrounding this scene in the workplace, and sickle and grapes around the death of Joseph. The way I begin a drawing like this is on a piece of tracing paper. Rather than working on this heavy French watercolor paper, which is rather expensive, I start out on a piece of tracing paper like this, which is itself a very fine paper. This is all cotton. All good drawing painting paper is cotton, not pulp, like a paperback book. So I start out on this, and I come up with all these various scenes and how I'm going to arrange the angels and the borders and that sort of thing. This is all done in pencil on this tracing paper. And then I can photograph this and send this down to Raleigh by email and just let people there see this and get feedback from them. And once we settled on this design, then I've got to take this design as it's on the tracing paper and transfer it onto the heavyweight watercolor paper. And the way I do that is with a graphite paper. So this paper is coated with graphite just like a pencil, and I put it underneath the tracing paper on top of the watercolor paper, and then I can simply go over the lines by pressing heavily with a pencil again, and it will transfer those lines right onto the page like this. So it's a very tedious process. I have to go through the whole design and transfer it onto this watercolor paper. And it really is a very much old school technique. And from that point forward, once I get it onto the good paper, I have to go over it and work on all the faces and hands and all the designs and make sure I'm happy with it all. And then it goes into a painting process where I add color to the entire design. And it's all done in watercolors. Watercolors that come in tubes like this. And most of those are European as well, the paper, the paint, everything, the brushes. It's all watercolors and very much old school. And you see, oh, it says Joe's Brain Jar. Everybody here is a comedian. So a little bit of red like this, which is very prominent in all the windows going to Raleigh, like that. One nice technique with watercolors to get the page wet first, and then you can put the paint on it and it sort of bleeds very nicely, runs like that. So anyway, you can see it's a very tedious process, takes forever to do this. It, you know, painting that in is probably a week's worth of work. Then when I'm finally done, I'm still not finished, I have to ink in all the places where the lead lines will be. So all these black lines you see in this, in the real stained glass window, that will be lines of lead caming. And what I, the technique I use to illustrate those, I use antique fountain pens rather than felt tips or anything like that. I just happen to like fountain pens. And I've got three of them here. One of them is very fine, very skinny lines. And then I have yet another one, a little bit thicker. And my favorite of all, I don't know how old these are. These might be, you know, 50-year-old pens. I've got one that makes a nice thick line and several more after that. So then I have to go through and ink around all these things. And then when I'm finally done with it, I can photograph it and send it down to Raleigh and make sure everybody's happy with it. And once we get final approval on it, then the next step is I turn it over to Neil and he blows it up digitally, starting out with a photographing process here in my studio.